Earth was covered with massive insects around 300 million years ago, before the reign of giant dinosaurs. These massive insects were not only a part of the Earth's ecosystems, but also a diverse range of marine life, including early versions of sharks and a 6-foot-long amphibian. Hello and welcome to the Meta Magics. During the Carboniferous period, the planet's land masses began to form, leading to the formation of Pangaea, a supercontinent. The environment was dominated by wet woodlands. Insects were one of the most notable species during this time, with the Meganeura being one of the most well-known. This insect could fly for up to 75 centimeters and was carnivorous, chasing down other insects and tiny amphibians. Another significant issue in Earth's history was the oxygen levels during this time period. At the time, atmospheric oxygen levels were as high as 35%, which is as high as 21% we now breathe. Oxygen was an essential component in insect gigantism, and it caused these insects to grow so large due to their lack of a circulatory system that transports oxygen. Instead, oxygen was transported directly to their tissues via a network of small tubes known as the trachea. Oxygen poisoning was another reason why insects developed to this size. Too much oxygen in the body can produce free radicals and unstable chemicals that can cause harm to cells and DNA. Insects were coerced into becoming this large due to the toxicity of oxygen, which can lead to nausea, breathing difficulties, and neurological system impacts. The Carboniferous period saw the emergence of the first seed-bearing plants, resulting in more diversified ecosystems than had ever been seen before. However, it was discovered that this was not a dinosaur, but one of the earliest reptiles to emerge. Another aspect of Earth that changed dramatically during this time period was the atmosphere. When the first land masses began to merge, the climate changed into an ice house Earth condition, with temperatures plummeting and ice forming. Sheets developed mostly in the southern hemisphere. As the massive land masses began to merge, wind patterns and global climate changed, and rainforests collapsed, resulting in a decrease in formerly thriving animals and vegetation. As a result, oxygen levels decreased, leading to the extinction of our gigantic insects. Small insects had better habitats due to lower oxygen levels and drier environments, while early reptiles took over, making the terrain more challenging for insects. In conclusion, the Carboniferous period was a transformative time in Earth's history, with the formation of Pangaea, the formation of land masses, and the emergence of massive insects. Understanding the significance of oxygen and the impact of these events on our planet's ecosystems is crucial for future research and understanding. What will happen at this juncture in history? That seems like a story for another time. Stay tuned for more.